A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I'm Daphne Shalit, Assistant Professor from the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering and Convener of Institutions Innovation Council, hosting today's program. I welcome all of you for today's session on Why IP is Important in Academia, organized by Institutions Innovation Council in association with IPRCEL, Dr. T. Timmaya Institute of Technology, PGF. Intellectual property is key aspect for economic development. Now I invite our Vice Principal Sir, Dr. H.G. Shenoy, President of Institutions Innovation Council, to render the welcome address. Over to you, sir.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, good. Very good afternoon and warm welcome to all. I am privileged to offer welcome address for this special session on Why IP is Important to Academia, held virtually. I take this opportunity to thank our beloved president of Golden Valley Education Trust, Dr. T. Venkatvardhan, for his support and best wishes. On this occasion, let me extend a warm and hearty welcome to our esteemed guest, Dr. C.R. Rene Robin, Professor and Dean Innovations, Sairam Group of Institutions, Chennai, who has readily accepted our invitation and will enlighten us on the importance of intellectual properties to academia. Welcome you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I extend my warm welcome to our principal, Dr. Syed Arif, our dean, Professor Rukmini Divakaran, and all the members of Dr. TTIT family, including teaching and non-teaching staff and students, to this session. So I request all of you to actively participate in this session and make it as an interactive session. Clarify all the doubts and make it as a memorable session. Thank you. Thank you, Vandana.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the warm welcome. And now I welcome Professor Vijay Geeta Ma'am, Associate Professor from the Department of Electronics and Communication, to introduce the resource person for today's session. Over to you, ma'am.
Thank you, madam. Good afternoon, one and all. Now I am profoundly delighted to take an opportunity to introduce today's speaker, Dr. C.R. Rene Robin, Professor and Dean Innovation at Sairam Group of Institutions, Chennai. Sir has received his ME in Specialization of Computer Science and Engineering and obtained a PhD in the same field from Anna University, Chennai. He has an experience of more than 20 years in both teaching and research field. He has taken various responsibilities, such as Head of the Department of Computer Science and Engineering, Joint Director for Approval, Affiliations and Accreditations, Associate Dean, Nodal Officer for National Skills Qualifications Framework and Scheme of UGC. And also, Sir is a Project Head for Skill Development Projects funded by Deen Dayal Upadhyaya Gramin Kaushalya Yojana, recognized by Government of India, and Tamil Nadu State Rural Livelihood Missions, Government of Tamil Nadu. His area of interest are ontological engineering, knowledge management, e-learning, and semantic web. Sir is a recognized supervisor of Anna University to guide PhD research scholar in the area of computer science and engineering. 6 students have successfully completed the PhD program. 3 students have submitted their thesis, and currently 6 research scholars are doing their research under him. He is a doctor committee member for various universities or Anna University, Satyabhama University, Wells University and VIT University, Chennai. He is a lifetime member of several professional bodies like ISTE, IEEE and ACM. Sir has received a mentor award from IBM for the Great Mind Challenge in 2011, Young IT Professional Award in 2012 by Computer Society of India, and Teaching Excellence Award by Indo Global Educational Summit in 2013. In recognition of his community development service, YMCA Madras honored him with Lifetime Service Award in the year of 2018. Currently, he is serving as a Goodwill Ambassador for the Plastic Free Tamil Nadu project. During this lockdown period from March 2020, he has trained more than 3,500 teachers on digital tools for effective teaching and learning process. Sir has published more than 75 national and international journals and conferences and published books and technical chapters, and also served as a resource person for more than 25 webinars. With this brief introduction, we would like to invite today's session speaker, Dr. C. R. Rini Robin, sir. We welcome you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Thank you. Participants, during the session, whenever you've got doubts, kindly post your questions in the chat box. Your queries will be answered at the end of the session. I hand over the session to Dr. Rini Robin, sir. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Can you please confirm my audio and video, my screen sharing, everything is perfect?
Yes, sir. You're audible, sir. And the screen is also being shared.
Be able to see the first slide?
Yes. Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes, yes. So, very good afternoon to all. I'm very happy to be here to share my knowledge on why IP is important to academia. I'm very delighted to be here, and my heartfelt thanks to the organizers of from Dr. T. Timmaya Institute of Technology, Karnataka, for inviting me, especially Daphne ma'am, for contacting me to share my knowledge to the student and faculty community, especially on intellectual property right. It's very important for the education institutions because the recent days we are more talking on innovation ecosystem, intellectual property right, and almost all the components of the, if you see the top of this presentation, you could see innovation institutions, innovation council, MHRD's innovation cell. They are all focusing on innovation. It's a recent trend in the higher education of Government of India. Government of India is taking a lot of initiatives with respect to innovation and intellectual property right. Intellectual property right is one of the important component of innovation ecosystem. Since I am the Dean Innovation of Sairam Group of Institution, promoting this innovation ecosystem in institutions, so it's my passion to spread this message, or being an evangelist to spread this message of intellectual property right and innovation ecosystem to various institutions, various educational organizations, the importance of intellectual property right. So the potential from where we can take the intellectual property right, what is the role of the teaching institutions with respect to intellectual property right and innovation ecosystem. If you take any higher education institutions, the recent days we are more talking on startup. Gone are the days we are not focused on, even you never hear this word startups. So but recent days we are more focusing, and whenever you visit the websites like AICT, UGC, Ministry of Education, IIC, NISP, the predominant the terminologies are startups, intellectual property rights, innovations. So the startups and intellectual property rights so are being considered as major pillars of higher education. So gone all the days, people would say that the academia, teaching rank, university rank, and pass percentage, we have given so much importance for those components. So to know about intellectual property right, you must have clear understanding on few terminologies. The terminologies, the first terminology is discovery, and the second terminology is invention. So the discovery, the difference between discovery and invention, the example I can give, Columbus discovered America, Vasco da Gama discovered India. So finding out something already in existence, that is nothing but discovery. But what is invention is nothing but the Thomas Alva Edison have invented electric bulb. Underline the word invented. It has not been there already. So he found out something new. So that is coming under invention. Then you might be confused with these two words. What is invention and what is innovation? Innovation. So we are now talking more about innovation rather than invention. So I said Thomas Alva Edison have invented electric bulb. but you and me are not using the same bulb. Are we using the same electric bulb which has been invented by Thomas Alva Edison? No. We are using the innovative product in the form of LED bulb to save our power. So that is nothing but innovation. You can make innovation over any existing inventions. It may be a product, it may be a process. So inserting new components, new features, and we can claim it as an invention, innovation. When I was taken up the charge as Dean Innovation, I was basically, I'm a professor of computer science engineering, more interested in academic teaching, doing research, guiding students, devoted around 20 years for that purpose. And when I got this elevation as Dean Innovation, I was very particular on knowing about innovation. So I was searching to know about or understand the real meaning of innovation. After several days of search, I got convinced because of this particular equation. So innovation is nothing but, or innovation is equal to invention multiplied by commercialization. Invention is nothing but your new idea. Commercialization is nothing but making money out of it. When you not adding, when you multiply it, you know the power of multiplication. You know power of multiplication. So the invention multiplied by commercialization is nothing but innovation. You may have some idea, new idea, fantastic idea, but you are not able to making money out of it. Uber is a very good idea. Idea multiplied by commercialization. He brought his idea into a product and he commercialized it. So it became innovation. At the same time, you may have high potential to invest a lot of money, but if you don't have any new idea, you cannot claim it's an innovation. But innovation is equal to invention multiplied by commercialization. So the time has come, education institution, to think about commercialization. Think about commercialization. So if you have innovation, then this session is going to help you how to innovate and how to protect your innovation and how to commercialize it. If you have your invention, then you can go for intellectual property right. And based on that, you can set up a small business unit. Setting up a small business unit, and this will be called as a startup for a few years, 2 years or 3 years. Over a period of time, it will become an enterprise. When it become enterprise, you'll call it as entrepreneurship. So entrepreneurship, you cannot make it immediately. So a lot of statistics, Government of India, AICT will ask for the percentage of students being converted into entrepreneurship and other things. So you need to bring your idea, your bright idea will be converted into a product. When you convert it into a product, it must be protected with the help of intellectual property, right? And you have to setting up a small business unit called startup. And when you flourish on it, it will become an entrepreneurship. Okay, this is what the ecosystem, the hierarchy of the innovation ecosystem. So let me touch up some of the important initiatives of Government of India. So you would have heard about National Innovation Startup Policy. I hope your institution has registered and completed the policy framing as well as the policy implementation phase is going on. If you are not being a part of it, try to be a part of it. So before that, you would have already established. Since you have already institution innovation council, so you can go for innovation, national innovation startup policy. So I said, no, we are not much aware of the commercializing part. Education institution not much focusing on commercialization. But I really honor and admire the idea and hard work of Professor Ashok Jhunjhunwala, professor of IIT Madras. He started this kind of ecosystem in IIT Madras long back. The Government of India has appointed him as the chairman for the National Innovation Startup Policy. government has released its own policy, and the Minister of Higher Education has insisted the institutions to frame their own policy to convert or to promote the innovation ecosystem. So we are all in under this process. Successfully, Sairam Institution, we have completed the NISP policy formulation, and we are moving towards the policy implementation along with IIC. And we have Arya, you would have experienced all the things you have done can be showcased and will be recognized through Arya. Yukti 2.0, I have a few slides, dedicated slides for Yukti 2.0 and Kabila. These are all the various institutions of the various initiatives of Government of India. And you are well aware of the norms and of IIC, since your institution has become already an IIC member. So Kabila is a scheme, it's an objective of Kabila is to recognize, facilitate the intellectual property right innovation and best practices of higher education institution. When if you are planning for intellectual property right patent filing, and so the Kabila scheme will sponsor 50% of the amount you can claim from Government of India through this Kabila scheme. And this is what the hierarchy of NISP, IIC and ARIA. Though IIC has been introduced earlier, NISP is the first step. Every institution must have their own policy, National Innovation and Startup Policy. What kind of policy? You can frame your own policy based on the guidelines given by the Ministry of Education. So once the policies are framed, you have to implement everything through IIC. The institutions having IIC don't see NISP as a separate body. Okay, so you both NISP and IIC has to work together. So clearly they have given this policy formulation is nothing but NISP, and when you come for implementation, it will be implemented by the group of dedicated faculty member of Institutions Innovation Council. Once all this thing, not only the, see, I think there are 27 events have been recommended by IIC. But yesterday I have attended one program conducted by NISP. They said you can have beyond or more than the events recommended by IIC. Okay. So a lot of events, if you surf internet, know about startups and other things, you'll be knowing, we'll get a lot of ideas, because I am devoted most of my times for innovation and innovation activities. So I'm learning, I'm attending a lot of training programs. So I'm getting a lot of information. So wherever I go, I used to share the knowledge to institutions and the students and faculty members. So once, after implementing everything, you can go for ARIA, policy impact creation. So actual ranking of institutions on innovation achievements. So the government, Ministry of Education will recognize your institution based on the events and the active participation with respect to innovation ecosystem. Okay. So the wonderful scheme to promote the student innovation, faculty innovation, even faculty staff innovation and the institution innovation is Yukti 2.0. Yukti 2.0 is a portal where a student or a faculty member or a staff can share or can submit their idea. It may be in any stage. It may be in proof of concept stage, or it may be in the design prototype stage, or it may be in a product level seeking for commercialization, or sometimes you may be seeking for some mentorship, sometimes you may be seeking for some sponsorship. So this is a place, unique place is created by Government of India. There you can upload your innovation or idea. So registration, you can register as a student, faculty or staff. You can register as an education institution on behalf of student, faculty and staff. Startup created by student, faculty and staff. Institutions, incubator on behalf of startups created by student, faculty and staff. I do not know whether you have any startup in your campus. I do not know whether you have any institution incubator. But the days are coming, every institution must focus on creating student startup inside the campus, faculty startup inside the campus, because this COVID has a lot of lesson to us. One of the lessons is you cannot depend on one income. So the possible, wherever it is possible, you have to have the potential. So even the institutions are encouraging. So Sairam Institution, which where I'm working, is keep on insisting our faculty members to set up their own startup. So it you may face some hurdles in the beginning, but over a period of time, you will definitely get revenue, because India is a place where India is a very good business hub. Even the abroad people are focusing on India. Why don't people like us, the technical people and the knowledge people, why don't we get a market? So we have 130 crores of people, the highly populated people. People are in highly demand for any product. So you can set up your own startup, and the institution must have their own institute in incubation. NISP is recommending that 1% of the budget, total budget, should be allocated for this purpose. And the sector-wise submission, this visualization I have taken from the Yukti 2.0 website, where the sector-wise, the sectors like healthcare, food processing, fashion and textiles, electronics and IoT, education, defense. So the people have submitted their ideas. No, they have pooled their ideas and given this visualization. So majority of the people have submitted their idea on healthcare and pharma, then agriculture and allied industries. Okay. So nowadays people are started giving more importance on agriculture. So being a student, being a faculty members, we can focus on this, what best we can give to the farmers. And the statewide distribution, there is a distribution there. The ICTI 2.0 submission, based on the submission of Tamil Nadu is leading with the 6,425 ideas have been registered with ICTI 2.0. Maharashtra is in the second place. They have submitted 2,749 ideas. And Karnataka is getting third place with the submission 1,703 ideas. So if you want to increase this, if your college is really contributing, so ideas, you need not go to or run anywhere to get ideas. Ideas, idea hubs are with you, and the students' projects, and the students are the real ideators, and the institution must provide the platform to showcase their ideas, and the faculty members must should learn how to respect the students' ideas. And after seeing these two visualizations, it's my guess that in next, what this ICTI 2.0 is going to do is there will be an institution-wise distribution in the future. So if you submit more ideas in ICTI 2.0, your name will be coming there. Okay. So with respect to the government of Karnataka's initiatives, I have collected some information that the Karnataka government is having Startup Karnataka scheme. And I know the activities various through Startup Karnataka. It is promoting a lot of innovation activities. So far, they have 58 centers across Karnataka, and Karnataka state has having 47 innovation hub and 6 centers of excellence, 5 technology business incubator. So this is scheme startup policy 2015, started in 2015 for 5-year scheme, and now they have enhanced. Karnataka's innovation framework, they have dedicated framework. The vision of this Karnataka's innovation framework is towards a world-class startup ecosystem through strategic investment and policy interventions, leveraging the robust innovation climate. So you could see a lot of information with respect to the government of Karnataka has taken a lot of initiative, and a lot of seed funds are available, so institutions can avail to set up their startup and to commercialize it. Okay, so keep in your mind, this is the website, startup.karnataka.government.india. So you can get a lot of things. Okay, the government of India has taken a lot of initiatives. So one of its wonderful initiatives is the Atal Academy, AACD Training and Learning Academy. So recently I have completed a course on patent drafting and filing. It's a 1-week program. So today I am interacting with you for an hour. But these courses are very much useful for teachers and students to know more about patent, intellectual property right, innovation ecosystems. So a lot of programs they're offering every month. Every lot of institutions across the country is offering different programs. I encourage teachers and students to enroll your name and get certificates. And innovation, I'm talking in front of you as a capacity of innovation ambassador recognized by the Ministry of Education. I have completed a course. It's a 1 month course, the innovation ambassador course. This opportunity is available for everyone. So I encourage you. So when you go through or when you attend this kind of courses, I know you are all very busy. In spite of all your busy schedule, you have devoted some time on learning, because teaching is a lifelong process, and we cannot teach without learning. Okay, so and these are all the latest or trending topics and trending systems. So we must know what is actually happening around us. So these courses are very much helpful for us to know about the innovation ecosystem. So the days are coming, we have to devote more time on innovation ecosystem. Let's come to the today's discussion on intellectual property right. Okay, so you're all very familiar with movable properties and immovable property. Okay, so can you able to identify, or can you unmute your mic and say what is this particular thing which I am showing? It's an immovable property. So it is a house. Can you able to identify, if anyone of you can able to identify, please unmute your mic and say what is this one? Participants, I hope you are all listening.
A car, sir.
Second one. This one. One house.
House.
Yeah, house.
Building.
Yeah, building. Who's building this one? Any idea? I'll give you a clue. It's a house of a famous cricketer. Don't we have any cricketer here? It's a famous Indian cricketer's house. Don't know?
Sachin Tendulkar.
Yeah, very good. What's your name?
Sir, this is Dr. Manjunath Babu, sir.
Okay, sir. Congratulations, sir. You have identified. So, let's give a big round of applause to sir, as clearly identified. So, it's an innovative house, no? Sachin Tendulkar Mumbai house. So, there is a virtual tour is there in YouTube. If you are more interested, you can see after my talk, not now. Okay, so we are very familiar with movable properties and immovable properties. So, but in addition that, we have one more property that is related to our intellectual. It is nothing but intellectual property. So normally, the wealth of a person will be determined by the amount of movable property and immovable property. So, if I use I will be judged by the car which I am using. If I have a Tesla car, everybody will see it as an autonomous car. Elon Musk has made a revolution in the automobile industry. Okay, so if I have Audi car, if I have BMW car, so based on that, my wealth and my status will be determined. And the house, how much the built-in area, where I'm residing, is all speaking a lot. But in addition to that, the days are coming, your wealth will be determined, your status will be determined by the amount of intellectual property you possess. Can you able to imagine this? Days are coming. So that's what this kind of awareness programs are being arranged by the institutions and government of India. How much important you are giving for movable property, how much important you are giving for the immovable property. So that much important you need to give for intellectual property. My entire presentation is on intellectual property. Since great inventions, see, we are all engineers, so we know the power of this wheel, engineering is a cyclic process. Wheel is representing an engineering process. So there will be a development life cycle for every engineering. If there is no development life cycle, then that field won't be considered as an engineering field. We have to salute people, those who invented, had made a lot of revolution. And fire, so seeing that there is no heating process, and today's situation, we are heating without cooking. So discovery of fire, it's a debate where this fire is a discovery and paper is another. We are all talking about paper. I just want to introduce one more thing. Fresh paper. Are you aware of fresh paper? It's an innovative product given by the Kavita Shukla. See, the Kavita, this is the childhood picture of Kavita, Kavita Shukla, and she's with her grandma, because Kavita Shukla is always talks about his grandmother. Wherever she goes, she used to talk about. Okay, I will play a small video. Can you kindly confirm my video is visible or not? Fresh paper, a small video, please. It's a 1 minute video. Just to know about what is fresh paper.
It all actually started when I was in middle school and I was visiting my grandma in India. My mom warned me to be really careful about drinking the tap water. I accidentally drank almost an entire cup. But my grandma made this mixture of different spices and gave me like this murky brown spice tea, and I ended up not getting sick. As soon as I got back home, I started to do little experiments in my garage where I was taking some of the spices and adding them to samples of dirty pond water. And then a few weeks later, they looked totally clean. They didn't have anything growing in them. One day I was grocery shopping with my mom, and I noticed that all the strawberries seemed to have some fuzz growing on the bottom. That was when I had that first aha moment where I thought, you know, I wonder what would happen if I dipped berries in my mixture. The results were just unbelievable. And I kept trying different mixtures. I tried to think of different ways to use what I learned. And eventually I put the spice into a paper, and I called it fresh paper. That's kind of how this came about.
Yes, this fresh paper is an innovative product of invented by Kavita Shukla. Now he is in the United States. The origin is Indian origin. So he I will show you what is fresh paper and how we can use. You know, every day we are, you know, how much food and vegetables we are wasting at our house or restaurants, and in order to protect it, the Kavita is a founder and CEO of the Fresh Glow and the inventor of fresh paper, a simple innovation taking on the massive global change of food waste. And her story of a simple beginning, a belief and the empowerment was the subject of short film by Hollywood director. So she became very famous, and she became an entrepreneur by her invention fresh paper. Okay, so you can also, we see a lot of her videos are available. And the Sense Smart S folding umbrella, you would have heard about the umbrella, but then normally when you use umbrella, so if the wind is high, then automatically it will fold. No, so this particular invention, this innovation, they have they have designed in such a way, so used the aerodynamic concept here, designed with the principles of aerodynamic. This particular innovation, the speed can handle up to 60 kilometers per head. Even sometimes when we go two wheeler, and if you use umbrella, we cannot able to go. It will not withstand the wind flow. Okay, but this umbrella will stand 60 kilometers per hour wind. So see the product specification are also here. The extended length is 70 centimeter, folder length is 24 centimeter, and so other specification are here. So now after seeing this diagram, you will get clear a picture about what is invention and what is innovation. Okay, so invention is nothing but the umbrella which we are using, and innovation is nothing but they have made something, they have introduced some features in the existing product. And we are all engineers. We have to salute the invention made by the Scottish inventor James Watt. He introduced this, invented this steam engine in 1763 and 1775. Why I'm talking about the steam engine is we are all talking about Industry 4.0, and we are slowly migrating to Industry 5.0. but where the industrial revolution has started So Industry 1.0 started immediately after the invention of steam engine. Okay, and if you see the growth of internet, there were only 111 hosts were connected with internet in 1977. I was born, and it became 213 in 1981. It became 582 in 1983, 84,000. So today, almost all the people are connected with. So, and how you can promote from the academia, how we can promote, you can encourage students to participate in various competitions. Okay, one of the royal competition is the Asian India Hackathon 2021. Last time, first time they have launched for Asian. So I am talking at the higher level, but even next level, you can focus on hackathon being organized by Ministry of Education. And there will be a lot of hackathons and other innovative competitions. You ask your students to register, to pull them to participate so that they will get more idea. When they go and participate, they will be interacting with others. They will be knowing about the other students. Even nowadays, school students have started a lot of innovations, and the school students have setting their own startups. School students are being a role model as entrepreneurs. So it's all possible. So don't restrict them. You give maximum opportunity for your students. Definitely, your institution will enjoy the benefit of innovation. So this is what the entrepreneurship policy framework. There will be entrepreneurship problem, then supporting target groups, business startup support, startup financing. So it may be given by the, initially the institution can support with the help of some seed fund. But if you ask directly, go and ask the students to set up a startup, they may not, they are not financially sound to contribute for that. Okay, for that the faculty can contribute, the institution can contribute. So you have to help them to reduce the barriers, and finally so these are all various things related to the entrepreneurship framework. So the institution framework, entrepreneurship will only lock economic development if a proper institution setting is in place. Okay, so we have to think about entrepreneurship development, setting up of startups, bringing the, or providing a platform to students to showcase their ideas, helping them to convert their ideas into prototype with the help of a lot of boot camps and other thing. And we have to convert that prototype into product. Once the product is ready, we have to go for the intellectual, protect the intellectual property right. If you have patent in your hand, then you can attract more number of investors, outside national investors and international investors. You need not do anything. And we'll talk about licensing, product licensing to the business people, so that you will get revenue out of it. These are all various avenues for commercializing your ideas. So this is the startup ecosystem framework, so where the main focus is student innovation and student startup. We have the pillars like innovation development, entrepreneurship exposure and skill development, technology commercialization, startup service and startup faculty. So faculty must be trained or built on the platform, entrepreneurship scientist, faculty plus entrepreneurship student base. So they all will contribute for this ecosystem. And the major problem here, the lack of awareness. So even after, you maybe there may be a group of students, 50 or 60 students are attending this webinar. Even definitely after completing my webinar, you will get some awareness about it, which may be new things. Okay, so lack of awareness, lack of motivation, lack of experimental learning tracks. We are not much concentrating on this project-based learning and experimentational learning. We are lacking on it, and we have to remove those things, and we have to encourage. And lack of relevant skills. So you need to conduct a lot of boot camps. So I normally encourage the department, as you conduct training program, you need to conduct them. Don't depend on the IIC will provide this. Even the institutions or the faculty members who are representing from the department can take initiative at the department level to promote this innovation ecosystem among the students. Lack of dedicated infrastructure and facilities. So nowadays, the government of India has given a lot of provision. Idea lab has been introduced. The fabrication lab has been introduced. Atal lab has been introduced. So why Government of India is taking this much of initiatives to to identify the institution really having the thirst on promoting innovation ecosystem? Okay, so be a part of this, and you may get, sometimes you may not get, but so you be a part of it. Whenever you see an advertisement, apply it, and over a period of time you will strengthen your infrastructure. And weak interdepartment linkage, it is very important. See, even the institutions having five department, the interaction happening between among the department is a challenging one, but it's all the old scenario. You come out, your break your barriers and come out from your comfort zone, try to have collaborated with the department of your own institutions. Then only you can interact with the other institutions. Okay, Dafi ma'am has called me, invited me. It's a kind of, I have no connection with this Timaya College of our institute. But one person has taken an initiative of inviting me. So this is a collaborative work. I am representing Sairam Engineering College, and I am sharing my knowledge to the college located in Karnataka. So I am representing Tamil Nadu, you are representing Karnataka. So yeah, some kind of collaboration is happening. Okay, and if you want to extend, even our collaboration is not going to end with this webinar. If you are interested, we can collaborate with more, or after this webinar, if you are interested to convert your idea into patent, or if you want any help to convert it into or getting a copyright or patent filing. So I'm here to help you. So this kind of collaboration is very required. And from where it will start, if the faculty members from the two departments, the same institution, not coming forward for collaboration, how you will be collaborating with other institution faculty member? How you will be collaborating with the professors of foreign countries? So these are all very required for today, because we are teaching the next generation people. So updating our knowledge and interactions, getting facility, grabbing the opportunities are the major responsibility of faculty members. And objective tree is a systematic, has been structure, the hierarchy have been given by the NISP. So you can follow it. And what is intellectual property, right? It's a term. So protecting intellectual property is something related to your mind, your creativity. In one word, I can, it is yours, something is yours. Okay, and intellectual property right is protecting your property. How you are protecting your car, how you are protecting your land. So similarly, you can protect. So in order to avoid somebody's licensing, you can provide licensing, you can get partnership with the people, business people, so that you will get revenue. And we are living in a competitive world, so we need to promote our business. It is very important. And different types of intellectual property rights are here. We have industrial design, we have trademark, we have trade secret, we have geographical indication, we have patent, we have copyright. These are all various types of intellectual property right. So design, industrial design is an example. I have given a bottle, Coca-Cola bottle. It got a lot of transformation, and now we are using this kind of. So this is the design of Coca-Cola bottle in the year 1899. And it has a lot of transformation, and finally end up with this one. So design, industrial design is based on the front view of the product, back view of the side view, right view, top view, bottom view, and isomorphic view. Okay, so any product, even the even the whistle of the cooker, it has its own design, industrial design pattern. Okay, so any product, knowingly or unknowingly, you may not aware of it. Even the flask which I'm using, it has an intellectual property. The pen which I'm using, it has its own intellectual property. Okay, the mobile I'm using, so all the product, whatever I'm seeing here, even the chair in front of me, table in front of me, the computer monitor in front of me, keyboard in front of me, mouse in front of me, okay, everything, the pen I'm using, even the stapler I'm using, okay, even the remote I'm using, you do not know, but people have already protected their ideas in the form of patent. Okay. Trademark is the next one. It's a simple or a small picture. By looking at this, you'll be knowing about the brand. So here, Google, Facebook, Coca-Cola, Yahoo, Apple. So I have given some example. Can you able to identify which trademark is this one? In order to test your IQ, I have given few example samples. Can you anyone unmute your mic and say what is this? I know everybody will say this one. Can anyone of you unmute your mic and say what is this? This particular thing is. Are you there?
Apple.
Yeah. Okay. This one is Alan Shuley. Okay. This is Jayalukos, and this is Hotel Sarana Bhavan. It's a very vegetarian hotel, Sarana Bhavan. So by looking this simple, you will be identifying the brand. Okay. So you need to create your own branding. Okay. How you have your institution will be identified by your logo. Okay. And the validity periods are given. Then the intellectual property, the geographic indication is very important. Can you able to identify what is this particular sari? Can you able to identify the name of the sari? Yes or no? I have taken a search net and got this.
Kanchipuram sari.
No, it's Mysore silk. I normally put Kanchipuram silk. Since I am interactive with Karnataka people, I have taken this picture, Mysore silk sari. Okay, so then this dog, are you aware of this dog? This Rajabalayam, Tamil Nadu, is a part of Tamil Nadu. And I have given a lot of pictures of Karnataka with respect to the banana and the petals and the soap. So these are all. So we need to, similarly, if we have identified any unique product with respect to your region, so don't delay, because India has lost several geographical indication because of lack of knowledge on geographical indication. Okay, so we need to go for, and national wise, agriculture, Darjeeling tea, handicraft, as you said, Kanchipuram silk is a famous silk manufacturer, Mysore sandal silk, and foodstuff, the Rajasthan, the Pagantri Puchya, or so Tirunelveli halwa in Coimbatore, sorry, in Tirunelveli halwa is very famous. In Tamil Nadu, Palkova, the Milkova is very famous in. Then there was a dispute between the two states, Odisha and Rasagula, Odisha and West Bengal for the Rasagula. And it came to court, and court has given this judgment based on small, minute changes. They have given this geographical indication to both states by saying that this Bengal Rasagula is white in color and Odisha Rasagula is light brown in color. Texture is spongy and it's soft in Odisha and is sweet in taste and not very sweet in taste. Based on small difference, they have given it to both the states. And the next thing is copyright is the intellectual property rights is copyright. You can go for the copyright for your literature, your book, when you write a paper, your book and your new process. If you have any unique process for your institution, your department, you can go for copywriting, film, dramatic, then music, artistic, sound recording. So painting, sculpture, drawing, diagram, map, chart, plan, engraving. So you can go for copy. Nobody will copy your things. So it is valid, 60 years validity you have. And you can, if you want to transfer it, you can transfer by a return statement to any publisher or any employer or the copyright society. Okay, so patent is nothing but patent is an exclusive right, because we are all engineers and engineering faculty members, students. You can focus on the patent. So if you have a product, then you can go for patent. Patent is an exclusive right granted to anyone who invents new or improved product or process by the government. So other two, so you can have 20 years validity from the date of filing, and the patent will be granted based on three parameters. One is novelty. The invention must be new or not known to public before filing. So inventive steps. So you have to describe the inventive steps, and industrial application to whom you are developing this product is very important. It must be useful to the society. So based on these three parameters, the grant will be provided. So in India, the patent, we have patent office, Indian Patent Office, coming under Ministry of Commerce, Government of India, is the only authorized body to grant patent. We have four offices located in four major cities: Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, and Kolkata. We have patent the intellectual property right IP offices. We have once if you get an idea, immediately you can go for provisional application. Need not wait for the product development, and even the specification is not complete. You can go for registration, and you will be getting 12 months time to complete your the specification. So you can take 12 months to complete your specification, because idea is very important. Once the idea is you got idea, you have to go for filing. Then you have to give the, it will come for publication. Publication is nothing but making visible to everyone. Once the idea is visible, published, everybody can see it. So if any objection, the patent office will receive the objection, and they have their own mechanism to find the plagiarism, and based on that you will be intimated for the first report. Examination report will be coming to you, and you have to answer for it. Everything is okay, you will be granted the patent. Okay, we have several forms: form 0, form 1, form 1, 2, 3, 9, 18, and various fees are available. Once everything is clear, you will be getting a patent certificate like this. Okay, this is what the most inviting for any people, those who are really have the thirst on getting a patent. Okay, and patent search is an important art. Okay, I will quickly take a small demo. So kindly help me. So I am taking you to the patent office, the website, official website. Sorry, I will explain this Indian patent office. Okay, we have different searching mechanism. The first one is Google patent. So how we are searching our research paper with the help of Google Scholar. Similarly, Google has its own database named Google patent, and Indian patent office, US patent office, SpaceNet is nothing but European patent database. Okay, I will give a small demo on Indian patent office. Okay, so I am taking a virtual tour on this. The website is ip.gov.in. Okay, where you could see, can you able to see this public search? Here there is an option called a public search. I'm clicking this public search. Okay, so here for public search, there are other subdivision: patent, trademark, design. So I'm going to search a patent. Okay, so it is asking you to the next, you are about to proceed to external website. Click OK to proceed. Yes. Okay, so where you have lot of parameters to search a patent, don't get afraid of seeing all those things. So you, since you are not aware of any other parameters, say for example application date, title, abstract, complete specification, application number, patent number, application name. Okay, so you're not aware of it, but you are if you are really interested to know about some thrust areas. Okay, could you able to see, someone unmute your mic and say, would you like to see patent has been filed in Indian patent office with respect to your domain? Can you unmute your mic and say, let us proceed based on your domain of interest. Yes, one of you please, your research area, your related research area. Daphne ma'am, you are representing EEE department, am I right?
Yes sir. Yes,
okay
sir.
Then I will search e-vehicle. Yes, e-vehicle. Yes. Okay. Okay, so I have given enter e-vehicle. Okay, I'm very much interested on the people, those who have submitted filed their application for so don't bother about other fields. If you know it, you can type it. Otherwise, need not fill up all the details. Okay, so I'm giving the captcha. Yeah, hope. See, I have the number of patent filed with respect to e-vehicle is 16,230. Okay, so all the patent with respect to the e-vehicle will be displayed here. Okay, so let me take an electric vehicle acceleration enhancer system. Okay, would you like to see, ma'am, the specification? Are you interested to know about its specification?
Yes, sir.
Okay, here you have an option, application number. Okay, I am clicking this application number. It gives the entire details about the things. See, the name of the title, invention title, when it is published, publication number, when it is published, see, September 3rd, very recently, this month. Today, 8th September, 3rd September, it is published, okay? Field of intervention is computer science. You want to know the inventors? Yeah, see, people like you and me. Mahib Singh, Assistant Professor, Mechanical Engineering, ITS Engineering College, 46 Knowledge Park 3, Greater Noida, Uttar Pradesh. So, Director, Mechanical Engineering, student. See, by looking this, you can see how a professor is dedicated or collaborating with the student, as well as HOD, faculty member, and two students. Okay, similarly, you can file your patent for your student projects. Okay, let us see the application. Would you like to see the applications? There is an option, view application status. So this searching will be very much helpful to you when a student approaching you. If you know this particular searching techniques, you can take the documents and you can compare the student idea, and you can guide them in a very proper way. Okay, here the student status are available, filed, publication. So these two processes, they have completed, it's indicated with the green. So all other processes are yet to complete. So if you want to view document, there is an option to view the document, view documents. Okay, so complete specification is available. That's what I said, once it is published, it is visible, it is available for everyone. But it's not till granted, okay. So by seeing that, if you can see that it is same idea being already published, you can also write to the patent office. They have their own mechanism too. So entire process, complete specifications are available here. So it is something like your project report, but patent drafting, while people use some kind of terminology, legal terminologies and other things they will use. Okay. So drawings, would you like to see the design? So this is what the drawing of their innovation. This is how we can see these things. I have a YouTube channel where I will share the link where I have discussed almost all the searching pattern. So you can also go through it and explore on pattern searching. Why pattern searching is important is, now I tell you, a few years back when I was trying a person to file a pattern, initially, they demanded 5,000 rupees for searching alone. And there is no guarantee that they will apply. Go for filing. Okay, if after searching, if they say that it is already available, then I have to drop my idea. Okay, but this particular technique which I am discussing with you, if you are familiar with this, definitely you can enhance your knowledge, and you can, whenever your students approaching. So I normally encourage teachers, those who are guiding the students, must know these things, because if you are technically strong, you can guide the students properly, and at the same time, you can take his idea. You can refine his idea at any level. Finally, you can help them to convert his idea into a product and pattern. So it is a win-win process. Once an idea is protected with the help of a pattern, you will be getting your credit, your institution will be getting the credit, and students will be getting their credit. Okay, so don't miss this kind of opportunity. So I am sharing one video, one video where I have discussed, it's around a 2 hours talk. So I have discussed almost all the pattern searching. So take some time. Anyway, I will share the link to Daphne ma'am in the later case also. My website, my YouTube channel is Rene Robin. You can see a lot of videos with respect to innovation, with respect to national education policy, with respect to intellectual property right, and a few technical things. And so this is a wonderful scheme of Government of India, Women Scientists scheme. So the women can target this. It's a 1 year program. 1 month training will be given at Delhi office, and remaining 11 months you will be placed at any one of the office, Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi, or Chennai. And after 1 year completion, you can start your own things, or you can come back to your institutions and you can be a facilitator of intellectual property right. Days are coming, this kind of skill will be more demanded in education institutions. I have small statistics, state-wise filing pattern in the year 2080, where Maharashtra is topping with 4,194, Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Delhi, Telangana, it's going like this. And the top 10 applicants for patents from academic institutions, 10 institutions they have given. So Indian Institute of Technology, Chandigarh University, Shilani University, Amit University, SRM, Chandigarh Group of Colleges, Bharat University, Indian Institute of Science, Calgary University, Lovely Professional University, Punjab. So if you apply, if you file more patent, your institution will come top 10. Okay. So I am a sustainable development goal promoter. Wherever I go, I normally promote sustainable development goal. So sometimes you may ask that where I will go for getting the ideas. So if you focus on, if you have thorough knowledge on these 17 sustainable goals, so automatically your students will think about it, okay, and try to encourage your students to start their problem from society. If you start your problem, if you formulate your project from the library, your end product will landed at library in form of some other paper. But rather, if you formulate your problem from society or village, from industry, it will directly go to village. So encourage students to arrange village visit. I'm in Sairam Institution, I'm recommending, as we are arranging industrial visit, we need to arrange village visit. Take the students to villages. Ask them to, with the help of Unnat Bharan, with the help of NCC, NSS, make them to stay 2 to 3 days in villages. Ask them to study their real need, how the technology can help them to enhance their life, their livelihood. If your idea, if you get some idea, then help them to convert it into a product. All the ecosystem, the components of the ecosystem will be solved or addressed. If you get a problem from the village, you can set up your own startup. You can, over a period of time, you will become an entrepreneur. You will go for intellectual property right, incubation, everything. And whenever a government is announcing an award, a competition, you can present this idea. You'll be recognized the Vishwakarma Award and other awards, the Student Innovation Awards. So if you have proper idea, and proper ideas are nourished or mentored in a proper way, then there won't be any problem of getting recognition. You'll get your recognition on time. So okay, this is what I have taken from Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, Design Lab. See how people are working. I was really impressed. I have taken this picture from their website. Impact is not just the production of innovation, it's a process of innovation. And the people are, how social related people, problems they have taken and working on it. It's really inspired me. And do you have any kind of ecosystem in your institutions? So try to promote it. And we have in Sairam Institution, we are linking all our students' projects with the sustainable development goals. This what the overall statistics summed in goals are mapped with the projects. The small visualization, we have solutions for department visualization and other things. So encourage students to take this sustainable development goals as their benchmark. Ask them to contribute, bring their ideas, even if they're small ideas, encourage them. And sometimes they may not, if they are not completing, transfer this project to the next batch. Okay, so you have to help, the institution has to help. And you have to promote your experiment on avoid plastics, because I am promoting the schools and colleges about the avoid of plastics. No poverty, zero hunger. So how we can address this no poverty and zero hunger? In India, we are living in a heterogeneous society where one side you can see a lot of people starving. Other side, we are wasting our food in hotels and wedding halls. Okay. So in order to feed these people, what you can do, you can cook and provide them. And how many days you will cook for them? But if we create a platform where we map this demand and the supply, then that would be the real contribution from as a technocrat. Then if you have any experimentation, any idea for physical health, any idea for quality education, during this pandemic period, how many students have struggled for not getting proper internet connectivity and so on. So if you have any solution for that, do you have any idea for gender equality? Do you have any idea for clean water and sanitation? Do you have any idea for affordable and clean energy? Do you have any idea for decent work and economic growth? Do you have any idea for promoting innovations at schools and colleges? Do you have any idea for reduced inequalities? Do you have any idea for smart cities? Being India is promoting the smart cities at various level. Do you have an idea for responsible consumption and production? Do you have any idea for climate change and global warming? Do you have any idea for quality life? Do you have any idea for ensuring universal human values? Do you have any idea for developing positive attitude? Do you have any idea for inculcate professional ethics? It may be a product, it may be a process. Come out your ideas. Why? These are all the examples. Uber, the world's largest taxi company, owns no vehicle. Facebook, the world's most popular media owner, creates no content. Alibaba, the most valuable retailer, has no inventory. Airbnb, BNB, the world's largest accommodation provider, owns no real estate. They brought their real or bright idea and they have converted in their product and launched into the society. And we, India, as mentioned earlier, we have 130 crores people, and the global people are targeting India as their business hub, seeing India as a business hub. Why don't you and me developing a technology, launching it to our own market, giving it to our own people and make money out of it? Simple example is Tayathon. Tayathon is an important initiative of Government of India. Why? Even if you go to all mall shops, buy a small doll, the Indian dolls are not available. We have a lot of tradition, but we lost our traditions. We have to bring back all our tradition back to show to the world that India is a knowledgeable, India is a knowledge hub. And if you and me are focused or work towards that, very soon the globe or the universe will accept India as a developed nation. Make this a challenge. Finally, I want to conclude with a small encouragement of Hackathon India mantra. Innovations lead to new creation. New creations lead to bigger action. Bigger actions lead to progress of nation. This may contact details. So if you have any questions, you can ask me. Thank you so much for this wonderful opportunity to share my knowledge. So there are a lot of videos that are available in my YouTube channel. Kindly visit my YouTube channel and over to the organizers.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for a very informative session, sir. Sir, do you have got a query?
Yes, ma'am.
Before proposing for research funding, is it mandatory to publish a patent or paper for a new innovative prototype?
Yes. So, because it is based on the number of proposal the funding agent receive. Say, for example, if they receive more number of funds, it will be considered as one of the evaluating criteria. If you have pattern, it will add more or it will enrich your application.
Sir, there is one doubt from my side.
Yes, sir.
So what is the difference between inventor and applicant in that filing a pattern?
Yeah. So when you publish a paper in a journal, if there are two authors, both will share the credibility 50-50%. If there are three authors, first two authors will get will share 60%, 30-30, and the third author will get 40% credit. If there are four authors, all four authors will equally share. But there is no upper limit of inventors in the patent. But yeah, but you have to applicant, you have to mention one person, and all other inventors will get the same credit. Got it, sir?
Thank you, sir. There's one more query.
Yes, ma'am.
Can we transfer research tools and materials from another institution?
I couldn't get your point. Can you transfer research tool
and materials to and from another institution, like from our institution to another institution?
So what tool? Say example, the your college and my college. Okay, what tool you are transferring?
So Manjunath sir, you can unmute and ask your question.
Yeah, two institution, Thimaiyan Institute and Sairam Institute. What is your doubt now?
Sir, my question is, if our institution is in collaborative with another institution.
Say, for example, Sairam Institution.
What are the research we are carrying out? So, we will be making use of some research tools. So, those research tools, can it be transferred from our institution to their institution or from their institution to ours? Is it possible?
Research tool owned by you are asking, or the open source tools?
Open source tool.
Open source tool anybody can use. Open source tool anybody can use, sir. Okay. And if you have suppose any licensed product, if you have, I can collaborate with you. Okay. Suppose I have some licensed product and your institution may not have that facility, then you can come to our college and utilize this facility. So both institutions are have the agreement or understanding. Yes. And some out of which, if you get any paper or any patent, what you can do is we both can go for patent filing or publication. Now recent accreditations are expecting whether you are collaborating with other institutions, the collaborative research work, collaborative research publication, collaborative patent publications having higher value than the papers with the faculty members of the same institutions.
Thank you. Sir, and I have one more question, sir.
Yes.
So how much experimental evidence is needed before we can file a patent application?
So filing a patent in Indian patent based on the product, Indian patent office will provide a grant patent for a product. And even the softwares, they will not be considering. So copyright, we can go for copyright for softwares. The patentability is purely based on how you are describing your innovative steps and how you are describing, how you are claiming this product is going to help the industry. Three parameters. Patent grant will be provided based on three parameters.
Thank you, sir.
Even a small change in a product, that will be accepted. That will be accepted. You can claim.
Sir, one doubt, sir.
Yes, sir.
Only the hardwares are accepted or software patents are
accepted? Yes, sir. In India, the only hardwares, some product related application will be considered for a granting patent.
Okay.
But other Australian patent, the US patent, this criteria is not with other countries. That's what some people, you would have seen a lot of LinkedIn social media post Australian patent, US patent people. Why people are going for? Because of this reason.
Sir, if you are going for Australian patent, will it be applicable in India, sir?
Yes, sir. Yes. Even the patent, if one country if rejected, doesn't mean that it is universally rejected. If one country is rejecting, then you can go for other, you can knock the other door.
Thank you, sir. Queries from the participants. If you have queries, you can either unmute and ask or post your questions in the chat box.
I have given my YouTube link. Kindly use all the videos of mine. Whenever I come online, I used to stream my lectures. All the lectures are available there. It will be useful to you. You can share your friends, the students, those who are not attended. You can share it, subscribe it so that you will get a notification when I come next time online.
So thank you. Thank you for sharing your knowledge with us, sir. Sir, actually, we find very few resource person who are very familiar with IPR. So thank you for the wonderful session that you have shared with us.
Thank you. Thank you.
And yeah, we got to know about the innovations and startups and how to protect it with the help of intellectual property rights. So look, we actually look forward for your help. You know, to if we have any doubts in patent filing, sir, we'll reach out to you. We look forward for your guidance and help, sir.
Sure, ma'am. Sure, sure.
Thank you very much, sir. And now I invite Dr. Sridhar Kumar, sir, head of Department of Computer Science Engineering, to render the vote of thanks. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, madam. Good afternoon to all. On behalf of our management, president, principal, vice principal, and dean, it's my pleasure and privilege to present the vote of thanks to our one-day national webinar on session on why IP is important to academy in the association with IAC and IPR cells of Dr. TTIT KJ. First, I would like to convey my grateful thanks to our session chair, Dr. C.R. Rainey Robin, working as professor and dean, innovation, Sairam Group of Institution, Chennai. Sir has given a wonderful speech over the topic of IP, and the content of the session is very informative and very useful for us. So, likely for patent and trademark in geographical industrial design. Thank you, sir. I extend my thanks to our faculty members and the students, those who have participated for in our webinar. Last but not least, I thank to our member of IAC, IPR, have given a wonderful support to organize the webinar successfully. Thank you. Jai Hind.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you for the vote of thanks. Sir, Dr. Rene Robin, sir, I once again thank you for having accepted our invitation to deliver the talk today, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, ma'am. Other HODs can also be in touch with us for any other further research activities and patent of intellectual property rights. We are ready to support you and help you. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Actually, we do have doubts regarding the policy implementation of NISP. Like, we have already completed policy
formulation.
Formulation, and now we are in implementation stage.
Yes.
And we have a few queries, sir. So after the session, can we contact you with regard to that, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I am the NISP coordinator of our institution.
Oh, very great.
Even yesterday, we had a meeting with Deepan, sir, and Pooja, madam.
Yes, sir. Yesterday's session was there, sir, but I had few more queries.
Okay.
So,
okay.
So I can talk to you.
We will exchange our knowledge, ma'am. Because yeah. I will say whatever I know, I will connect. Otherwise, I will connect people.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Good luck.
Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you, one and all. Thank you. Thank you. Leading this program. Thank you all. Happy evening.
Thank you all.